started off with apologizing again because if you didn't catch my last video, it's linked in the description, but I apologize because I've been gone for a long time, and then what do? I leave again for a long time. That's all I can say. It's been busy, and it's been a transitional period for fishing. That transitional period that I'm talking about is from bass fishing to salmon fishing like I usually do. It's been a little, well, I really haven't had time to do that transition because I've been working so much. I am going to start salmon fishing very soon, actually. It's pretty much that time of the year. The one thing I'm waiting on is I'm trying to get a new salmon rod because the one I have is a little bit, let's just say it's deteriorating. Just a tad bit. But hopefully those videos will be coming up pretty soon. If you're still here, I appreciate you rocking with me. We're back. We're back uploading. We're ready to get stuff done. Okay, so let me tell you why the Megabass Vision 110 is hands down the best jerkbait on the market. Yes, this guy right here, the $25 piece of plastic. Why is it worth that much money, first off? What's the difference, second off? And should you get it? I'm gonna answer those questions real quick for you guys. Kind of comparing a couple different brands and just talking about a couple differences between them and such. So let's start off. $25, $24.99. There's some sites that you could find them for a little less than that, but main MSRP everywhere you're gonna look for the most part is $24.99. So 25 big ones, and that is that's a lot to spend on one lure in fishing when there's other brands that are selling jerk baits for $2.50. Why spend the extra money? Well, you're gonna have a lot of benefits with that higher end bait. Build quality, paint quality, paint schemes, paint colors, how many colors they have, balancing, casting distance, overall profile, hardware on it, like hooks and the snap rings. All that's going to be upgraded on the more expensive jerkbait. So the Megabass versus, let's say, well, this is a Cabela's Mean Eye Minnow. These are like $3-4. Very, very cheap, basically. And you can, I mean, just holding it up with in the light, I mean, you can see just holding them up, the paint is a lot different. It's a lot more glossy on the Megabass, which is right here. It's a lot more glossy. You can actually see a lot more fine details cut into the plastic. Camera probably won't pick it up. I gotta do a closer. There's definitely a difference there. And a lot of times that difference is everything. How realistic it looks. The Megabass is gonna look more realistic, like an actual bait fish, than that other one, the cheaper one. And like I said, that matters, and that will matter a lot. There will be times when that bass, you'll throw that cheaper jerk bait and you won't be getting bit, and then you switch to a Megabass if you have one and you throw it and you get bit. There's a reason for that. It's because it looks more realistic. I mean, it's got a slender profile to it, whereas this one's got a fatter profile to it. Now, I watched a video from the Hookup Tackle where they basically, he went over and discussed what everything, every color name that Megabass chooses, basically went over what it means. So for example, French Pearl US or GG Stain Reaction, something like that. Like, what does the GG mean? They have got it narrowed down to the point, researching what chemicals are in actual fish scales and then putting that on a paint, putting it on the fish. That right there should tell you there's nothing more realistic than that. Everybody knows about the Megabass Vision 110. And they know about the insane price. Which leads me to the next one. Price, is it worth $25? Yes, the reason being is because it outperforms everything at any other price point. Now you're probably thinking, hey, I can get a jerkbait for $3. Like, for example, Cabela's, this is a little Mean Eye Minnow, it's like $3.99. It's cheaper jerkbait. They work, yes, you can catch fish on them, but then when you get to that point where they don't bite that jerkbait for whatever reason, maybe you've been smacking them on it all week and then they just stop. Maybe you wore them out, got them smarter, you throw that Megabass in there, 9 times out of 10, it's gonna get bit. So, why is that? Well, it's because Megabass goes above and beyond most other lure creator companies. The hooks that you get on Megabass Vision 110s are actually out barb, which means the barb is actually on the outside of the hook instead of the inside of the hook. Reason being is that it actually snags fish a little bit easier, because if you've ever seen underwater footage of a jerkbait and fish eating a jerkbait, a lot of times what they do is they come up to it and they either swipe it, don't go for it fully, or they suck it in real fast and spit it out. So basically having that out barb system just makes the hookup percentage go way up. It just snags them a little bit better. Not to mention that these are the stickiest hooks I've ever felt. I mean, they're great hooks, but they're very thin wire, which means you need to have pretty much the perfect rod for it, or otherwise you're gonna bend them out and you're gonna lose the fish. They're thin wire, but they're so sharp, which means basically when they try to swipe at it, if they touch that hook point even a little bit, they're hooked. Also, the balancing system and the weight cast transfer system is some of the smartest I've ever seen, and it works really well. A lot of times, I don't know if you've ever casted jerkbait or even a crankbait, and that thing starts to helicopter in the sky when you throw it, and it basically gives you like half the cast that you should have had. Megabass has, and not just Megabass, there's some other companies that do it too, but Megabass has got it down to pretty much the T. It's just two round BBs in there that when you cast, right in about the middle of your cast, so in the middle of your swing, the two BBs shoot to the back real fast and slam against the back, and what that does is it, one, kind of boosts the speed a little bit, but two, it makes it fly straight so it doesn't helicopter. Now let's talk a little bit about that profile of it. The profile is real slender. I'll hold it up again to a, we'll take a Lucky Craft pointer. This is an SP. It's actually a bigger profile. It's pretty fat. It's taller and it's wider than that Megabass Vision 110. As you can see, now the Megabass is longer. It's actually, well, this is a plus one, but the overall body without the bill is still longer than that Lucky Craft pointer. However, that Lucky Craft pointer is taller. It's also wider on the back and fatter on the belly. Now, when your bait fish are small is when that comes into play. Fall time, especially, the bait fish aren't big like they are in the spring. That more slender of a profile is gonna match that bait fish a lot more than that fat profile will. Now, obviously, these have their time and place. You know, you'd be throwing a bigger profile in the spring when they're hungry and the bait fish are typically bigger. That's all I got for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you found it a little bit informational. Maybe go buy one of these things, because they're worth the money. And you can find them on sale sometimes. And if you don't like it, you can go ahead and mail it to me and I'll use it. So thanks again. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button. Hit that bell notification right next to it to get notified every time I upload. And join the family. We're going to be doing a little bit of salmon fishing pretty soon. So stay tuned for that. I know a lot of you guys like that. And I will catch you guys on the next episode. Thanks for watching. Much appreciated. Don't forget to hit that like button. I got rich by my mama's crib. How much you willing to spend? This money don't mean shit. I still put them diamonds on my wrist. Make niggas see shit. But lately I've been on my deep shit. And then life is an L, and niggas don't know how I sleep it in. We'll keep it all away just to stay sane. Playing the same game. Ducking and dodging all my pain. Looking all my ways. Hey, shoot up a nigga in the face. Okay, it's back inside my brain. Now this shit isn't really the same. This shit ain't a game. So delirious, beast in a cage. You ain't furious, but I ain't fearing it. All my demons standing up in my face. Boiling in a minute, mate. Drink so dirty, in need of mate. Damn, dirty ass drink. It goes down, down, down when the plug is in town. Scripts is filled.